Today is Friday, April 28th, 2023, and we have a lot of announcements this morning, so buckle up.
I'm Suhana, along with Owen running the teleprompter, James running the mixer, and Amalia directing.
Happy birthday today to Wyatt F, and happy birthday over the weekend to Brooks B.
Come down sometime today for your birthday pencil.
We have no guest teachers today.
We are very excited to announce the winners for Science Fair.
For kindergarten, first place to Isabella S. for How Do Bees Make Honey? Second place to Carter B. for How Water Filtration System Works. Third place to Dylan G. for How Volcanoes Work.
First grade winners.
Woo!
First grade winners. First place to a group with Abigail F. and Sage L. for How Do Magnetiles Work. Second place to Austin W. for How Do Honeycombs Work. Third place to Quinn C. for Light to Dark.
Second grade winners. First place to a group with Gabriella B. and Peyton S. for Sipping Science Soda Effects on Our Teeth. Second place to Rika F. for Magnetastic Magnets, and third place to Sebastian F. for Going Bananas.
Third grade winners, first place to Rainer H. for Why Did the Statue of Liberty Turn Green? Second place to Maggie H. for Why Does My Cat Like Butter? And third place to a group with Cora M. and Cameron R. for What Caught the Tornado?
Fourth grade winners, first place to a group with James H., Amalia S., and Suhana S., oh my gosh, for electromagnetism. Second place to a group with Emerson H., Emily B., for harnessing human power. And third place to Valentina R., for mechanical systems of the human heart.
Fifth grade winners, first place to a group with Erica L. and Meredith L. for different flower and their uses. Second place goes to a group with Kai L. and Ronan A. for elephant toothpaste. And finally, third place goes to Britton C. for feel the burn.
Congratulations to all those winners. Can we please have all those who were announced to come down right now to the Learning Commons, because we are going to give you guys your medals and your certificates.
Okay, attention, all your summer birthday babies. Please listen up.
Starting on Monday, we will be announcing our summer birthdays along with our May birthdays. Here's how we'll do it. This coming Monday will be May 1st. So on Monday, we will announce birthdays for May 1st, June 1st, and July 1st. On Tuesday, when we announce birthdays for May 2nd, we'll also announce June 2nd and July 2nd birthdays. So summer birthday students, keep your ears open for your special birthday announcements coming up in May.
If you have an August birthday, that happens before school starts again in the fall. We will be announcing your birthdays when the new school year begins.
It's now time to pick the next two herd leaders. So my friend Caitlin, you can come around. Oh, actually, you know, we got to scoot you forward. You come share the spot with me over here.
Hi, friend. How are you?
Okay, you sit right down here. I'll stay right here. Drum roll, please. Our first winner is to Miss Chastain. Miss Chastain, you've got the special spot next year. Next year. I mean next week. When I say next year, what I really meant was next week. Miss Henderson, you've got the good spot next week. Thanks, Rockstar, for coming on and helping us out. That was so nice of you.
Thank you, Caitlin. Thank you, Caitlin. Now let's get to some shout-outs.
We got one for Miss Bird's entire class for showing amazing perseverance on iReady this week. I saw those scores, you guys, and holy cow, we had people growing hundreds of percents. Craziness. Awesome job. We got one for Sawyer P. and Miss Chastain. Sawyer has been working hard to set an amazing example to those around him. We are glad you are a part of the BRE family, and we know you will lead as big as the next star student. We have one for Ogis, Chase, and Sir. I don't want to mess her name. I say it sometimes wrong. Saranya just came to me. Thank you, my friends. Sometimes I mess it up. So sorry, Saranya. Thank you so much for being respectful and kind during recess. The junior recess coaches really appreciate it. We've got one for Neely B. and Miss Marzov. Neely was very kind and helpful to a classmate that was frustrated with an assignment. We've got one to Caden P. for Schaff. Caden was kind and helpful in math after he finished his assignment. Caden helped another classmate that was stuck on a problem too. That's from Miss Marzov. We've got one for Griffin W. and Miss Mazur. He was focused and gave his best effort on the iReady reading diagnostic. That's from Mr. Chastain. We got one for Henry K. in Miss Mazur from Mr. Chastain. He was focused and gave his best effort on the iReady reading diagnostic. We got one for Bruce B. in Miss Begnell. Bruce consistently does an awesome job of listening in class. Way to go. About that time, my friend.
I got more shout outs.
Holy cow. Mr. Rickman wanted to give some huge shout outs to Emily, Billy, Suhana, Amalia, Maribel, Julie O, and Miles for doing an amazing job running the BRE TV equipment last night. He also wanted to give a shout out to Miss Holden and Miss King for volunteering their time to help run the BRE TV during the extravaganza. Mr. Rick. Whoop! Whoop!
Mr. Rickman also owes a huge shout out to Miss Ryder, Charlie's mom, for hanging most of the art you see around the school. Mr. Rickman appreciates it so much. He would like to thank Coach W for getting BRE TV started at the extravaganza when we were shorthanded. Also, he cannot thank Miss Murdoch Jakeaway enough for consistently checking in on the art room last night and staying until the very end. Loaning us an umbrella in the driving rain and taking care of Mr. Rickman and his family.
The most important shout out, and I'm going to need to hear from this crowd on this one too, goes to Mr. Rickman and Ruthie and the Rickman family. Woo! For making. Oh, I just read what I want to read. The biggest shout out ever goes to Mr. Rickman, Mrs. Rickman, and Ruthie for making the stained glass station happen. It was so awesome last night, and kids had such an amazing time. So.
It most certainly would not have been possible without them. Mr. Rickman loves you.
Oh, Mr. Rickman loves you. All right, now, guess what's happening? You're not even going to believe it. The Buffalo, they're moving. They're going. Where are you going this week, Buff? Let's find out. Somewhere new. Brace yourselves. All right, we rolling with the music, peeps? All right, one's coming to you, Paisley E. and Miss Rumminger. Paisley is always so helpful and is kind, respectful, and hardworking. I can count on her whenever I need a helping hand. Way to go, Paisley. One's coming to you, Ainsling E. and Miss Bird, for having perseverance when it was hard and putting in the extra hard work when it took extra time. Love, Miss Bird. We got one for Connor K. from Miss Engel. Connor has been making it a priority to use his very best handwriting in class. It takes focus and endurance. We got one coming to you, Carlene K. and Miss Henderson. She was nominated for our Student of the Week for always working hard and being a good friend. I am so proud of you. Love, Miss H. We got one coming for you, Douglas G. and Miss Pringle. Douglas, your improvement in both your schoolwork and relationships with classmates this year has been amazing. Way to go. We got one coming to you, Joseph C. and Mr. Schlatter. Joseph rocked it on iReady Reading. I am so proud of all of your hard work. Woo! Holy cow, you guys, we don't know. The weather doesn't know which end is up right now. It's so crazy. The good news is Ninja Nation is still on like Donkey Kong. It will be happening in the gym. So that is super exciting. I love you. It's Friday. Can't wait to see you today.
Enjoy your weekend, Herd, and please stand and join us in the pledge.